Ja.
I am back and I have a really fun video for you guys today. I do have a couple of errands that I need to run. In my last vlog, I said in the beginning that I had to go to Sephora, but I never ended up going to Sephora even though I was downtown. So I'm gonna go do that today because I do need to go get a new foundation because mine is done and a new primer. But other than that, I'm going to be trying African food for the first time today.
Disclaimer, I've had jollof rice before.
I am so excited. If you are on TikTok, then you know, like, African food has been trending for, I don't even know how long it's been trending for on TikTok, but it's been on there for a little minute. And everybody's been trying fufu, and I really want to try it. I feel like I'm going to love it. Like, because I feel like African food isn't too far off from Caribbean food. And I eat Caribbean food all the time, being that I'm Caribbean. So I really think I'm gonna like fufu. There is a restaurant in Brooklyn that I found and I was reading up on their reviews and they say they really have really good food and they do sell fufu. So I'm gonna go to Sephora and everything, get what I need to get. Then I'm gonna go pick up the food and we're gonna come back and we're gonna have a little, basically a little mukbang. Like, I'm really excited. It's gonna be my first mukbang on my channel. And I'm just excited to try the food because I just love food. If you know me, you know that I love food. So I just finished doing my hair. As you can see, I got a little new hairstyle. This is an old wig, but I just revamped it and tried a new one because I had to wash my other one. As you can see, she's right there, she's drying. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get dressed and we're gonna get started with the day.
Y'all, I got my fufu. Oh my God.
Just came back to the house. I already washed my hands. And I heard when you're eating fufu to have like a little bowl with some water. So I have some here. I have my drink. I'm sorry y'all can't see my desk because of the way that my setup is. But I'm going to show y'all the food anyway. So in this bag, I have my fufu. I'm going to insert the clip of the place that I got it from. It's an African restaurant on Fulton. Today I got fufu, I got the pounded yam, fresh white yam fufu, and I also got it with the beef stew. And for the sauce, I got egusi, which is ground melon seeds steamed with spinach and dried fish. And altogether, my bill came up to... So I have it here. I'm gonna lay down some paper towel. Because I know in Nigerian culture, or I've been learning in Nigerian culture, that they eat this with their hands, which is not something new to me. As a Caribbean, we eat a lot of things with our hands, so this is nothing new. So I just want to put down a paper towel to catch any of my mess. Yeah, I'm so excited. Y'all do not understand. So here is the fufu. Just like all the videos I've seen on TikTok, it comes in this plastic wrap. I'm just going to take it out of the wrap. I'm always the type to smell my food, I'm sorry. Okay, I've had yam before, so this is not something like brand new to me. I've just never had it in this style. So I'm just gonna put my fufu right in front of me here. And y'all, the way that this stew looks, oh my God. So I'm guessing this right here is the egusi. And then you have the pieces of meat in it, and it is tomato based. I cannot wait. My mouth is like watering. So I just want to say a little prayer before I eat. Father God, thank you for this day. Thank you for giving me another day of life. And as I partake in this food, let it be nourishing to my body and bless those who's bless those who has made it. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. All right, y'all. So I'm just going to wet my hands because they say to wet your hands before you eat fufu. So I wet it. I washed them already. And they say to slap the fufu. Slap it. Y'all, I'm so excited. So... And they say to like mush it up in your hands. I'm gonna use this hand. Mush it up in your hands. I'm gonna just dip it in. And I think it's culture to just swallow it, but I'm gonna bite it first and then I'll swallow it. Y'all. No way. It's 10 times better than us. It's a little spicy, I'm not gonna lie.
is so good. All right, I'm gonna try to just swallow it. Yo, this is so good. Oh my God. It is 10 times better than I thought it was gonna be. I'm not even gonna lie. So I'm gonna just go ahead and finish up my food because I don't wanna just make it all about food. And then I'll come back at the end when I'm finished and give y'all my full review on trying fufu with egusi and beef stew from Buka, New York. So I'm finished my food. I didn't eat all of it because I kind of want to save some for my sister because she wants to try fufu too. Gave me a lot of food, but I have a lot of the stew left. I don't have that much of the actual fufu left, but hey, she would probably eat the rest of the stew with like, excuse me. Rice or something. I just want to come back and let you know my overall experience with eating fufu for the first time and how if I recommend it or not. First thing, I definitely do recommend it. I honestly feel like because, especially if you're of Caribbean descent or Caribbean culture, you will really like it. It's not that far off from stewed chicken. I mean, I feel like every Caribbean island makes stewed chicken a little bit different, but it's all the same kind of concept. So, yeah, it's not that far from stewed chicken. Basically, like, I would just say the stew is more like the stewed chicken. But instead of chicken, I have beef. And they added, like, more tomatoes, really. More tomatoes in it. And a little bit more spicy. As far as the egusi, that's something I've never had before. I mean, if you like spinach, you're probably going to like egusi. But the thing with fufu, if you want to eat it the way that culturally how Nigerians or Africans eat it, you are supposed to just swallow it. But if you want to bite it, the egusi might not be for you if you're a kind of texture kind of person because it is grounded up melon seeds. So take that, do with that what you will. But overall, I definitely do recommend. Hold on. I definitely do recommend it. It was amazing. It was amazing. It is a little bit spicy. I'm not like, it's a little bit spicy. If you like spicy food, then you'll be fine. But for me, I really don't like spicy food like that. But I will eat this over and over. Yeah, I definitely do recommend Buka. It is a black-owned business. You guys should definitely go support if you are in Brooklyn and you're trying to find affordable, authentic Nigerian food. It was amazing. I would definitely be going back. And that's basically it for the video. I'm sorry, guys. Please disregard my shirt. I just want to put on like basically a messy t-shirt so that way I don't mess up my shirt, even though I really didn't even mess it. Oh, I lied. I got some stew right there, but whatever. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure to give me a big thumbs up and make sure to click that subscribe button. If you haven't already, come on, we're trying to build back up the family. I would love for you to just keep coming back to my channel because I do have a lot of content coming for you guys. And also, leave a comment down below with some food that you guys would like me to try. I really don't mind trying food on my my channel, honestly. I wouldn't mind trying different cultured foods. So if you guys like it, I can make this into a series, you know, going around New York and finding different different cultural foods and trying it for you guys, and maybe you guys will go ahead and do the same. If you do end up going to Buka and liking the food, please leave a comment down below and let me know how you like it. I do want to thank you guys for the continued love and support. It does not go unnoticed. And until next time, I'll see you guys. Bye.